Bam! Under construction. Got my hat on. Does anybody know where this came from? Does anybody know where this hat? Who knows my stuff? Who knows where this came from? And if you hear a buzz, let me know, because I got a fan on. It's hotter than Hades in here. As a matter of fact, I think I might be in Hades. That could be a possibility. So, under construction. What's going on tonight, man? Everybody's rolling out early tonight. Jacob, are you the Chevy with the cute dog? I don't remember the cute dog. Unless there's Wendy Thuring. And everybody's lined up for the show tonight. So let's get this party started. Let me get my hard hat off. What is up tonight? How's everybody doing? Hope everybody's good. And we got some weird stuff going on tonight. I'm not sure exactly what it's going to be, but this really isn't the two-hour show. This is just the, hey, what's up? This is more like, hey, what are you doing? What do you got going on? Why you got a hard hat on? Where's that hard hat from? Some of you guys should know. But this is a just a discussion on the journey that I've been taking. About 30 days ago, I took a thought of how I would like to go to the next level, and what I would like to do, and where I'd like it to go to, and what I'd like to see. And I went back through a whole bunch of videos that I used to do, that I did do, put a bunch of stuff on TikTok, put a bunch of stuff on YouTube, looked at all kinds of different things. There's Sally, Jesse, Raphael, the glasses we all love. I don't know where that come from, but I'm okay with that. We need to look at, Jen is recording the Suns game for me to watch after BFU under construction. That's I even thought about that night, cause I love the Suns. I mean, I love the Suns because nobody else even plays sports here. There's no sports going on here. There's a rule that says that good weather and good athletics cannot ever be on the same plane. And I learned that. So once a person comes here, even if they have an immense amount of talent, somehow it goes by the wayside once they reach the airport. Like they get off the plane and go, wow, it's not snowing. Wow, it's not gray. You know what I want to do? Nothing. Okay, I want to do nothing. So that's kind of the curse of the valley. There is a valley curse that goes on with sports. So if you're not a sports fan, you're probably living in the right city. There's Steve Lines busting out. But by Wendy, her razor fund. Boom, already. Now, where's that money going to go? That money is going. And so since Steve Lines came out of the gate like a monster, I'm going to show you where we're getting next and where we're heading. Get ready. One, two, three, bam. That's it right there. Look at me. Look how happy I look. That's where that's one of the directions I'm heading. I don't know if it'll be an event on bike. So every fund that comes through here for the next whenever until I can buy that bike is where it's going. I'm going to buy an electric bike. And what you will see is that you will see me do reviews on different traveling systems to getting to the trail. Everybody knows it's got a truck. You can get there. But, you know, that last, if you're an Agua Fria or a Gila Bend, it's that last 3 miles or 2 miles that's kind of a bitch in any one of these places. And so I'm going to look at alternative ways to get to the trail, whether it be riding from the house on a KLR 650, some version of something like that. I already know putting a four-wheeler in the back of your truck can be done, but then you have to have the space, and then you have to have a license, and then you have to have insurance. Same with the motorcycle. So I'm looking at these motorized bicycles to see if would that get you that last 3 miles, and would it be fun, and would it be quicker, and would it save some wear and tear on your vehicle? That's in the future. That's where we're going next. I'm going to go down that road and boom, put it up there. That's the goal right there. And Steve Lyons got that going out right out of the gate. And that is much appreciated. because there's going to be some transportation stuff on there. We're going to talk about people that, you know, a lot of people know a lot about four-wheel drive, things like that. Some people don't. Some people don't know about, you know, air pressure. Some people don't know about having a jumper box. Some people don't know about, man, you get a ramp in the state of Arizona. I get one ramp. That's it. And the second ramp is done. And if I'm 10 miles off the path, then it'd be another good reason to have a damn bike. But that wouldn't be the purpose. But do you have a jumper box in your truck? I've got two jumper boxes in my truck right now. John's got jumper boxes. He's got a compressor. If you're going to do tire pressures, so we're going to get into the things that it takes to get to the trail. You know, if you're uncomfortable with that. So that's what we're going to start talking about, is things to get to the trail, staying at the trail. What would it be cool to be at Agua Fria overnight? Camping out, doing things like that. So the expansion of the channel will go into working on a lot of things that have to do with exploring.
It's too steep. What? It's too steep. Honey, Joe B said it was just right. He said all the family start on Mount Everest. Let's go, kids. Take the young one. She won't know any better.
I love Take the Young One. She won't know any better. Nobody else thinks that's funny, but I do. And I appreciate that, sir. The goal is up there, and we are $25 closer to the goal. And so that's what we're going to do. That's what we're going to find out. Maybe it'll work. Maybe it won't. You know, so that's going to be one of the things that we're going to work on. I mean, I know a lot about motorcycles. I know I've lived with four-wheelers all my life. I've got it. We have a family UTV. And those things are absolutely phenomenal, but you have to have the place and you have to have the storage and you have to have the trailer or you have to have the racks or you got to have all this different stuff. Now, again, you know, what would be easy? Would it be good? Would it be kind of neat to have a bike just in the back that you could throw out and put it back on and go down 2 miles, 1 mile, come back? I don't know. We're going to find that out though. So that's going to be one of the journeys and the goals as we move forward in this new adventure. Is we're going to find that out. We're going to find different things out that we need. You know, the other day when we were out, for example, I went and bought a first aid kit the other day, and those suckers are not cheap. But do you remember when we went to Pado, and do you remember one of these hands got ripped? I think I almost ripped my tattoo off my hand. I think that's where, maybe that was it. But man, I got hooked up on a fence. And man, it just ripped the piss out of my hand. And Wendy, hey, came to the rescue. And, you know, those are things as this box that we talked about building a box, and I actually have one now in the back of my truck. One of those black boxes with the yellow tops. I bought it at Sam's Club. And I tell you what, it's awesome. It's got a lid on it so I can suck it in there and it seals fairly well, not completely dust proof, but close. So all that stuff is in there. It just in case, cause you know, two times I got ripped up pretty good on the trail. And one time I used a dirty sock and one time cause of Wendy, she nursed it to health by just throwing the shit on it, making me scream. But other than that, but I knew it wasn't going to be infected. And, so that's where it's going. But see, a lot of things we're going to talk about. I've got capabilities to go get a bike, a bicycle. I got capabilities to get a bike, a motorcycle, and I already know four-wheelers and I already know UTVs, but we'll talk about those. Yeah, in a perfect world, if you had the place to put a UTV and you had the funds to get it, those are the most badass things that you could take four people on and run 50 miles an hour. But that's not always feasible. So we'll work all the different systems that are there. We'll talk about tire pressures. We'll talk about having the right box in your vehicle, whatever vehicle that is. I've got an entire box that's got a tire. It looked like Wendy's backpack with stuff in it that you don't see me pull out and I don't carry, but it's got winter clothes. It's got everything that you would need if you get stuck out there, not to die for that night. And so foods that you might want to take with you, things like that. So, you know, that's things to look at. And, you know, you know, I've had bikes, I've looked at bikes. I've gone a lot of, different routes and directions, but I think this adventure, I think it's Aventé, something like that, is very reasonably priced considering what you get. It'd be a good starter bike, man. I've been looking at that one that I posted when I posted the picture, I was looking at those. So it popped up and then Don Barry had fun with that. But it was kind of funny. I've looked at bikes. I've looked at just dirt bikes. I've looked at bikes I can actually leave from the house, because a part of this, I think that will bring in a lot more viewers as well, is the overland part of this deal as well. And bringing in not just when you go to a site, but hey, what if you stayed all night? What if you did this? What if you did that? And I'm with Eric. I'm a quad guy. I love quads. If you've got the space and you've got the capabilities, you can't beat a quad. But if you're wanting to just throw something in the back of the truck with no insurance, and again, it may not be feasible. That's why we need to go out. You need to go do that and see what's going to happen with that. I learned all I needed to know off-roading with John D. John D is an off-road fool. He knows his deal. But there's a lot of people that do. A cat in heat. What is there a difference between? Oh, just for that, Steve Lines. Just for that. What is, you're going to be my lead in all night tonight, man? I don't know if I keep up with the comments. Okay. So you guys know me, you know that I've had adventure. How many of you guys know me really well? How many people have seen this? For example, you've seen some dances before, right? You've seen me in action. You know my abilities. Okay. But have you seen this? Have you seen this one? Let's pull it up, and I'm not sure exactly how we're going to do it, but it's going to be a place where only group you, we're going to know everybody that's in it. You know, we talked about this vetting. We're going to talk about locations. We're going to talk about coordinates. We're going to talk about things like that, that I would never say on an open mic or an open area like that. That bike is a fat tire, Don Barry, as well. It is a fat tire bike. Damn, now I have another expense to look at into. Thanks. Exactly. Because, man, the videos I've been watching, Jacob, man, you talk about it, it would be fun to get to the locations versus beating the hell out of myself. So yeah, it's another expense, but it'll be a good one. Carry some emergency band-aids, antiseptic, burn, even sunscreen on you. There's going to be a lot of skits coming that I've been writing that are going to piss a lot of people off. Now, a lot of people will think they're incredibly funny, but there'll be a few people out there that will not be happy with me. Already going to tell you that. Okay, these bikes are anywhere from $1,400 to $10,000. Now, would you buy a $10,000 electric bike? No, not at all. But you're looking at about probably the one that I'm looking here in the corners, about $2,000. That's about $2,000. And the thing about it is you can throw it in the back and, but you know, there's a lot, by the time we get that much money, it's going to be a while, and I have a lot of time to be able to go into it and really see what they're about. But, I got a weird feeling that's a direction I'm going to go. And there are going to be more motorized vehicles on the channel. We're going to go out and expand out. I don't see it being any different what we're doing. Because if you're going, does it have a 1970 F-150? It has two 1976 F-150s, and they are awesome. I'm going to get two baskets. I'm going to get a basket in the front, Wendy, and then I'm going to get a basket in the back. And I might put you on the front. See that basket right there in the front? See that basket in the back? See that face? Ah! That's me. I'll probably be screaming when I'm on. On one of those baskets better be a first aid kit. I'll just tell you that already. That's for sure. But yes, there will be, because here's the thing. You have to then get out, right? And then you have to explore, and then you have to carry your stuff with you, and then you got to come home. Now, what I've learned so far is this. There are two styles. We won't get into depth on this because I'll do that when I go out and take the one out that we look at. I'll rent one or whatever I need to do. Is I'll go out and I'll try these out. Never explore alone, first rule. But what I'll do is I'll try them out and I'll say, hey, how does this work? What's the advantages? What's the disadvantages? Does it make sense? Is it just a ridiculous expense? Does it something? But I can tell you this. Usually the last 2 to 3 miles on any trail that you're going to, getting to there, is pain in the ass. I mean, it is. So what I know by my four-wheeler, right, that I can get there in about less than a third of the time it takes me to get there in my vehicle. On a four-wheeler, I can run most trails 30 miles plus an hour. And that's insane in a vehicle. You can't do that. And you could probably do that on a bike either. But again, then you're not using a trailer. There's trailer thought processes and all that. And if you have that and you have the capabilities and you like Eric's got that stuff, man, it's awesome. There's nothing wrong with that. But if you're going out in the stuff where I'm heading, would this make sense? And I can't tell you it would or it wouldn't until we go do it. You know, what would it really take? Let's say we went to Agua Fria just to throw a place out a lot of people know about. How many places could you see in a day on an electric bike if you dropped off at the corner? So let's say you drove all the way in till you make that right by that little Quijas right there, and you stopped and you dropped out and you went in. How much stuff could you see on a bike versus your vehicle just time-wise? I'll guarantee you probably 3 times as much. The only problem is, though, you know, what kind of distance you're going to get. So I'll break this down real quick from what I've learned. There's two vehicles. There's two vehicles right now. There's one that is pedal assist, which means it's more like a mountain bike, but you have to pedal. And then there's ones like this one, which you don't have to pedal. It has a throttle. So if you didn't want to pedal, you don't have to. And again, remembering that after you get done hiking up a cliff, or let's say you go someplace where you do a cliff dwelling or wherever, and you ride a rough road in, right? You ain't going to want to pedal home. I mean, that's the only thing that I keep thinking about, is that you ain't going to want to pedal home after you've climbed the side of a mountain. The other thing is, I thinking about motorcycles is, you know, let's say a KLR 650. That's a great, great motorcycle. That is awesome. You get parts all over the world. It's cheap. It's inexpensive. It's a good bike. It's okay on the highway. It's okay off the trails, but it works for both. But man, when you get done hiking up that hill again, man, there's something nice about being able to finally get in the vehicle and just sit down. And you might even, unless you're Eric, you turn on the air conditioner, but you know, there's something nice about getting that ride home. That's not a ride home that you're just beat up. See, that's the deal, is you're not just going out and riding around. You're going to go to a location where it's going to be a pain in the ass. It's going to take that stuff out of you. JPH, what's up? Luis Conde, Lahisha in Ajo, Arizona. That's right. Luis Conde, the great Leticia. I think old World War I tote goat would be good for Agua Fria and the trails. You know, the only problem is keeping those things alive and running. There's a Jeb, Sunstroke. Oh, there's JPH right there. What I missed that one. What was that one? Sunstroke. Break root and rule all the time. Some of the best times I've had, the scariest been by myself. There is something about be able to say about that. When I started to do adventures on my own, it makes the whole level should be played with the song Tequila. I think we have all the locations. So fat tire bike plus fat tire beer is good times. If I had fat tire bikes with fat tire beer, I better have two first aid kits. Just keep rolling the ASMR and they will eventually give us the money. Put the money in the baby. There's Bob Fitcher. What's up, Bob Fitcher? What's going on? $1,500 is about as low as you can spend on an electric fat tire bike. That's exactly right. That bike there is $2,100, and I think so far it's been the best value for a bike that I've seen. It will get 30-plus miles, maybe more if you pedal, but it'll get you 30 if you don't pedal. That's what he's saying. We will see. We will see what's up. And it has a throttle, and that's what they're saying. That one has a throttle. I looked at it today. To get an idea if that's somewhere down the road. He explained to me, he's pretty good. He's pretty good about, even though most guys that sell those bikes are all hardcore, like mountain bike guys, and they really don't want to talk to an adventure guy. We call that, what we're looking for. But I'm telling you what, I don't know if anybody saw those videos in Baja of those cave paintings on Facebook. Holy, that just popped in my head because I was thinking about traveling, that you can go to and on a mule. Now I'm going, I don't know how I'm going to get there. I don't know what I'm going to do, but I'm going to do it and it should be good. So hopefully we'll get this stuff going on, but put a lot of money in the basket, in that basket, Wendy basket. So yeah, that's Michael Jackson Shiz. What was that model bike? That is let me pull it back up and let me get the, and again, I'm still looking at all kinds of bikes. So it's just not, but the direction of heading that way is definitely something that is a Venton right there. A Venton. I've been looking at a bunch of them though. There's a bunch of cool stuff out there. There really is. Let's get back into the comments real quick. Don Berry, gas powered won't work here. Your situation is different though. Rock the crystals. Pee Wee Schreckler is right. Rock the crystals. You just get a dirt bike. You're awesome. Thank you, Ray. You know, I wonder where I've lost all my sidebars things because I've been working on trying to pull new stuff together. And it's been an interesting journey.
I found a meteor, Scott. I found a meteor. Oh my God, this thing's still hot. Bring me the oven mittens.
The oven mittens, right on. Thank you very much. That is awesome. You guys are awesome, and I appreciate you. Great show, but I'm off to Arapaho. Oh, you can't be going to. Oh, that's John D. You ain't going to Arapaho, are you? Exactly. Safe travels, John. Arapaho, that's south. Safe travels, my brother. Safe travels. So what I'm going to do is, for anybody that didn't know, I hate to do this because we've got 23 people on, and if I put this on, I'm going to lose about half of them. But, you know, I guess there's Oklahoma. Allen, what's up, Sooners? Sooner Boomers, what's going on? How you doing? We are getting ready. Let me show you where we came from. I already lost one person just saying I was going to put it up. But here is 10 minutes of what we have done over the last 11 to 12 years. And, Arapaho means airport. I don't know that stuff. Arapaho. Oh, that's right. He's dropping people off. He ain't going. There's Don Berry, enough to charge the bike once. You know, that's a start. A start to charge the bike is a start. And that's good enough to get started. And so that is much appreciated.
Well, I'll be damned. Is that Don Berry? I'll be
Bam! Thank you, Don Berry. Hey, I'll take a charge from here. That's the part. Hey, it's all good, Jake. Got to feed the algorithm. That's what it wants. It wants to be fed. So let's get this party started. Thank you, Don. Thank you, Rock the Crystals. Thank you, Steve Lines with his Arapaho means airport. I wonder if John knew that or he just got that. I bet he didn't know that. I bet he didn't know. There's Craig Tucson. What's up, Craig? He's got the fancy ride right there. Now look at it. Looks like he's in the cockpit. okay, here's where we came from, and then let's figure out where the hell we're going.
Welcome to another episode of Misfires and Legends, so hang on! Damn it, James!
Jay Shrek, Miss Lies and Legends. Would you like to find the Lost Dutchman's gold? Would you like to have an adventure? Yeah, hell, so do I. But you know what? I thought maybe the best place for a person that's never been out here to maybe experience this is, why don't we do a test?
Protect your rights. Have you been injured on the job? Have you maybe inhaled some asbestos? Have you maybe had some bad dope from the marijuana man? Have you been injured? Have you fallen off your couch? Maybe the couch was not built properly, and maybe the guy that built your couch was maybe he was high and he built one of the legs too short. Well, you have rights, and we're here to protect those rights.
Dr. J. Shrek here. I'm in Rocky Point, Mexico. Probably with the greatest tracker in Mexico, native Mexican right here. Your name, sir?
My name is Jaime Payan Torres Gonzalez Gutierrez and Martinez.
Can I just call you Eddie?
You can call me, yes, sir.
Okay.
Eduardo. Eduardo is Eddie. You can call me Eddie.
Okay. How long have you been tracking here in Mexico?
Well, I've been doing it for 10 years.
10 years?
We haven't been lucky.
Right.
What are you looking for?
Bigfoot.
I'm looking for the Bigfoot. You know the creature with the Bigfoot and the big Schwarzenegger?
I heard there's something in the ocean called Bigfoot.
In the ocean?
In the ocean.
I never heard that.
They said it's sort of on a boat, they said.
Boat?
On a boat. Damn crazy. But what I can do is point out where they have seen it before. So you can probably look at it and find it or something.
They say something about...
Maybe get a burrito and tell him, I got a burrito.
So he likes burritos.
He must be hungry.
Yes, he could be.
Because he's on the boat. How is he going to eat? He has to. They saw him driving a boat.
You did?
Yeah.
I saw that.
I saw him driving the boat.
Oh,
I'm not kidding.
You haven't had any marijuana, have you? Are you been drinking, my guess?
Let me see, my boss is looking at me.
Then I'm going to show you guys how to dissect. Put that right in that bag right there. What I'm going to show is I'm going to show you guys out here how when you're tracking animals, whether that be Bigfoot or any other type of animal, you can tell a lot about an animal by the scat that you'll find on the trail. It's really incredible how, I guess you could do it for humans if you wanted to, but later I'll get into how exactly you dissect that scat to maybe find out a lot about the animal you're tracking. You know, we talked a little earlier when he was on the trail about finding scat. So what we've done is we've collected our scat and we put it in this bag here with my lunch. Got it here with an apple. You know, probably she shouldn't do that because the apple could contaminate the scat, and you really don't want your scat contaminated. So I'm gonna cut off a chunk of that. I'll just eat a little scat with my apple, I guess, because that'd be easy. So I take a piece of scat, and first thing you do when you look at the fibers in it, you feel the different stiffnesses, the textures, things like that. And then you taste it. So you take the scat, put the scat in your mouth, kind of like wine. Wash your scat around, let it set, maybe a little sweet, maybe a little sour. Now by eating the scat, what that's really going to do for you is this. Already, the animal has berries, I feel berries, I feel I taste some type of leaves, ocotillo, yeah, and what you can do is you can kind of get an idea of what kind of diet that animal has, whether it's Bigfoot or a common baby ground squirrel, or doesn't matter, if it's got scat, you can eat it, and also if you take it in your mouth long enough, you can go a little deeper into just not the nutritional side of what the animal, but maybe this animal hated its mother. I can tell you, had a limp, his left leg probably was smashed somehow, maybe a boating accident. But I ain't gonna lie to you, this scat tastes like shit. Ugh. Guess what? No, you mean scat? Scat is shit? No, you're kidding me. Scat is... This is Jay Srack on the trail. Looking for Bigfoot. You son of a bitch, you're supposed to tell me that scat was what? Hey! And nudity prohibited. Come with me on the trail. Clothes, that is.
Bye. I changed my mind. If you got problems, go get you some help. Don't lift the rocks yourself. Get some help. Jay Shrek on the trail. Send me an ambulance.
Views later. Well, that's where in the hell we've been. And so don't expect it to get any better than that. That's the pinnacle of where I've been. And so that's some of the journey. Does anybody know where that hard hat that I was wearing, where this came from? Anybody know the answer to that? Especially our Spanish-speaking friends out there might know. That came from. I was just fairly curious, but so that's where we've been. One thing you'll notice is, man, there's a lot of change. We've made a lot of shorts in between that. We've done a lot of stuff. Now we go on to what the new show is going to be like. And you know what? I don't know what the hell is going to end up, how it's going to end up, but we're going to keep putting it out there, and we're going to keep, we're going to try to firehouse subs. We're going to try to get going on the new journey, and it will be a lot of the old journey with some new stuff. Like I said, there's a lot of skits out there. I've got a lot of videos coming up in just fun stuff as well. Crazy stuff like that in between going out and having adventures, how to get to the trail, what to do when you get to the trail, there'll be a show again that will be on, that will be closed. That will be we discuss things like this here, coordinates, how to get there, where to go, where to park, where to do, what to do, how to do it. Dean is speechless, and that takes a lot. And takes a lot. If I get Dean speechless, he's like me. He's not lacking words usually. But there'll be a program that will be closed. It will not be for the public. It will be for the explorers that are on this page. Everybody will be pretty much vetted out, and we will talk about locations in California. We will talk about it in Nevada. We will talk about them in Arizona, especially Arizona, but we will not shy away from people from other places. So hopefully as we expand this journey, why would I do that? Because there's people on this platform that are wanting to see locations. And I'm afraid the longer we wait, the less opportunity we will have to go see them. My biggest fear that I have is that people that are looking out for my best interest will shut places down. So again, I don't believe that these coordinates should be open to the public. Like anybody can come on and see them, but you know what? There are people out there that are what we stand for. And that is preservation. Allowing us to enjoy our heritage is my heritage as well as yours. This land should stay free. It should stay barbed wire free. And I will be coming on with a lot of skits again, that's going to piss off a lot of people, but those people piss me off. You know, when I saw the location in Gila Bend with that sign that I have shown many a time. I don't even know if you still, I still got that on this thing. I tell you what, history. And so we're going to talk about history on this channel as well. We're going to talk about locations and what history is there for you. The cool thing about locations in New Mexico and Utah and California and here, the fact that these crossroads that these people took, whether it be, and I'm listening to what I'm saying, 30,000 years ago. Yeah, I just pissed some people off there. 30,000 years ago that were in the state of Arizona saw, and as far back as 100 years or 200 years or 150 years, right? Or 50 years, right? Or maybe we're the new travelers, right? But you know what? This needs to stay open. So the people on this channel are going to have a resource to be able to go to. And I don't know exactly how I'm going to be able to set that up. It will not be on this channel as far as what we're doing tonight. It will not be open like this. If we go to a Facebook page on one night a month or two times a month, something like that, we are going to discuss coordinates. We are going to discuss locations. We are going to discuss, but we're also going to be vetted. So be prepared for that, because we need to see as much stuff as we can before they decide for my best interest that I can't see it. So, you know, and I hope that everyone else, Zoom possibility, definitely, because I do believe that. And I do believe that we are on a crash collision with people that, thought processes are that my best interest is that I stay home. And I just don't agree with that. You know, hey, and again, I'll fight for their freedom to do whatever they want to do. But my goal is to be able to see as many locations I can see. Now, here's what we have. We are looking in the state of Arizona alone, not counting mines, not counting cabins, not counting historical locations. We are looking at, I'm going to estimate that there is probably 3,500 locations to 5,000 locations in the state of Arizona alone is what I'm going to guesstimate. And that is a guess, because where do I come up with that number? I'm looking at right now probably 800 just ancient sites, not including any of the historical caves, all that stuff, just that. And I know I don't have close to all of them. So there's probably another 1,600 locations. And that's how much stuff is out there. So that's what we got going on, and that's where we're heading, but it will not be on an open channel. And, now I'll make fun of them on this open channel, but I will not, you know, and hey, you know what? I respect anybody that, you know, they do what they do. God love them. But I also know that when you see signs like that, that's a sign of the times. And I believe that their motivation is good. I mean, I believe that they care, and I believe that in their heart of hearts, it's what they believe is right. But also the road to hell is paved with good intentions as well. And I believe that, and without us as input in this, and it's a one-sided deal, I believe it's bullshit, to be honest with you. Let's just call it what I see it. So that's the direction we're going. You're going to see what to take to the trail, how to get to the trail, what to do when you get to the trail, different ways to get to the trail, things that you need to get to these locations, places to stop on the way back, places to get a fine meal or a piece of pie or something on your journey that you're going to actually really use and do. And, you know, because here's the thing. If you know the area that you're going to and what you, I could see people doing this. I could see people saying, hey, I'm going to Tombstone, for example, and people in the group would say, who's been to Tombstone? Boom. Somebody would pop off. Okay, I've been there. Well, what's to see? Hey, well, I'd like to see this, this, and this. Okay, so you go to Tombstone. What's around Tombstone? Well, you got Johnny Ringo's grave. Okay, where's that at? Okay, where is the cemetery? How far are you from Bisbee? You know, how could you get a full run so when you go to these locations, you get maximum seeing or sightseeing when you're going on trips, and use this as a travel planner. You know, if you're going to Sears Point, Do you want to know where Freedom Rock's at? Do you want to know where the Stanwyck station is? Do you want to know that kind of stuff? So when you go there, you get the full deal. And also, Joe B says, eat at Johnny Ringo Steakhouse. Drinks are on Johnny. I like that. That's the direction. Thank you, C. I appreciate it, brother. I've lost all my friends because they choose to stay home instead of explore. But you got friends here, my brother Jacob. Look how you found us out of the blue. We thought you were like the police or something. We thought you'd be infiltrating us. I'd look at that funny it was cool to meet you. I'm glad you came out. And I hope to get more people out like that. There's Tecumseh Little Bear. I was wondering where the hell you've been. And Florence is better. Everything's better at Florence. So that's the goal right there, right? So, boom. This is your brain. This is your brain on BFE. Man, you guys are awesome. I will see you later. I'll have more update on the channel, what's going on next week. John, thank you all. And appreciate everybody showing up tonight. And appreciate the ones that were able to contribute to the bike fund, like Mr. Don Barry, like Rock the Crystals, like Steve Lyons. I appreciate that very much. Much appreciated. And we do have Jacob is a Patreon, which I appreciate also. And sometimes I don't mention that because you don't see it on here, but I do appreciate that channel as well. And so thank you, Jacob. And everybody have a great evening, and I will see you later. Good night. Adios, amigo.